back. We're going to kind of stay in the art realm a little bit and mix in a little history.
Yes.
I'm Larry Aarons, Aaron Muffaletto, and we have a new guest on the couch.
Yes, and we have Albuquerque Museum joining us today, and we have a curator with the museum, Deb Baines. So thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for having us.
And Albuquerque Museum has been here forever, so if you haven't been there yet, where have you been?
Love those guys. They're great.
Well, thank you. And you're also an acclaimed published author of Albuquerque history.
We've had a few come out of the museum. We've done publications on Rio Grande weavings, the Alvarado Hotel, lots of art exhibition catalogs.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
Now you have a new exhibit opening, and it's focusing on a little slice of Mexican culture, which is very interesting, the equestrian culture in Mexico.
Yes, we're very happy to have it. It's called Arte en la Charrería, the Artisanship of Mexican Equestrian Culture. And really fabulous exhibit coming out of International Art and Artists in Washington, D.C., focusing on the collection of the family of Gumaro Gonzalez. They came from Nuevo León, and through three generations, they've built this really fabulous collection. It's considered the best equestrian collection in Mexico, focusing on their national sport.
So we're putting some images up on the screen here. What are we looking at?
We're looking at a Gran Gala saddle. The saddle is a really good example of a traditional functional object used in the charreada or rodeo. But it really emphasizes kind of the epitome of the artisanship that goes into creating these objects. It really moves into the realm of art. And so the fancy leather work, the stamping, the silver work, and then the pitiada, the little maguey cactus embroidery, all over the saddle just makes it this incredible object. And that's there on exhibit at the museum now.
And we have a picture of a dress as well.
That's the China Poblana dress.
Oh, okay.
The China Poblana is considered the essence of the Mexican woman. She comes from a myth and a story that has to do with a Chinese woman who came from Puebla, Mexico, ultimately ends up to be a servant. It embodies the perfect Mexican woman.
And has this influence has this style influenced New Mexico here?
It is, and there are actually a large number of charreria associations in the United States and some in the New Mexico area as well, so very popular north of the border.
So how big is this collection? What are people going to see?
It's about 150 objects, and they range from the late 19th century into the 20th century in contemporary examples.
And this is a temporary exhibit. So how long do we have to see this?
You have a couple of months. It closes on March 30th. We have several programs going on as well. Roland Rodriguez is going to come in and talk about the charreria tradition on February 5th. And then on our third Thursday event in March, we'll be celebrating women in the arts. And we'll be talking about the China Poblana and the Adelita dresses on that day as well.
How old are these pieces? What's the age range of this?
The collection, the Gumaro Gonzalez collection, goes back to the 1800s when the charreria tradition really developed fully. And the most recent example, I believe, is in the early 2000s in this collection.
Wow.
A lot of the spurs are really amazing. Most of them come from the mid-19th century, inlaid silver into iron. Really fabulous artistic examples that are early in this exhibit.
Now, I'm curious, is this a moving exhibit, or how did this come to Albuquerque?
Well, the Albuquerque Museum is really fortunate to get a great and wide variety of traveling exhibits, and we try to bring Albuquerque to the world and the world to Albuquerque, and this is one way that we can do that is through traveling exhibits.
Yeah.
Some of them rotate as often as every 3 months, and then some stay with us longer. So on this one, we have a couple of months to host this marvelous exhibit.
That's got to be fun when you get this in, you're opening crates and boxes, and it's like Christmas morning.
Yeah. Right?
All this stuff is coming out. When they send you an exhibit like this, do they give you all the background and the the details so you can organize it?
They sure do. It starts usually about a year or two out with contracts and working up the negotiations of what will be brought. Of course, now everything is digitized. You used to get a huge library of files. Now everything's digitized, right? And you get crate lists and object lists, and you know advance what the objects look like and what the information is about them. They send the label copy in digital form now, so everything is generated. In this case, for the exhibit, we generated the graphics ourselves from PDFs that they provided, and created the design and layout for the exhibit, which is primarily based on the categories of materials.
Sure.
So you'll get to see all the bridles and the spurs and the saddles, and then in another area you'll get to see the women's special social dresses, and then the working outfits as well.
Mm. Deb, this is great. Invite everybody down to see it at the Albuquerque Museum. It's a wonderful exhibit. I'm looking forward to seeing it myself.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Deb Baines, who is Curator of History at Albuquerque Museum, here on The Morning Brew. Aaron and I have more on this show for Tuesday after this timeout.